Good morning.
Good morning.
You are so quiet. First of all, I'd like to thank my brother priests who show up in the great numbers. Thank you for your presence. Lisa Ritz, our superintendent with the staff of the office. Thank you for preparing this celebration, this Mass. And all of you, the principals, and the faculty and members of the different schools in around our diocese, thank you for coming. Thank you for being here. We are celebrating 100 years of the diocese. We are in a very special moment, how we celebrate 100 years of history, how we give thanks to God in the way that we are today. That through all this time, the church was building what it is today. And you have been part of that as teachers, as principals in your schools, building up, working with souls and hearts, helping them to understand the beauty of what we have and how we can prepare them to be missionaries for another 50 years, 100 years more. How we can help them to continue the journey that we are living and forming disciples. That is the mission of our schools. Something that was very interesting in my experience visiting some of the schools. When the kids are coming to the church for Mass, it's something always that I hear again and again and again when the kids are coming into the church. But looks like that doesn't apply for the teachers. You know, when the kids are coming into the church, you ask them to be quiet. But there was a symphony here inside of the church before Mass until someone was in charge and make you quiet. What make you so excited that doesn't matter if you were inside of the church, you keep talking? What was there who moved you to talk, to laugh, to say hi? What was there? I was a little bit scared before Mass because one of the teachers, he said to me, "Are you ready?" I said, "Oh God." You know, that question right away is, I'm ready for a test? Oh, the teachers are taking notes and putting me grades. But that is the fun of having life. And in the celebration that we have today with the Feast of the Transfiguration, how Jesus invited these three disciples to come up to the mountain, and he showed him who he was, the Transfiguration. We talk about a new school year. New. How excited are we to embark in this new school year as new? And the kids who are coming, they are in the new school year. They are coming to us, they are coming to you. How you are preparing yourselves to let them see that is something new waiting for them. Helping to understand in your own area of expertise the beauty of what we believe, the beauty of creation, the beauty of the universe. Focus in our faith, and each one of you in your own area is responsible to let the kid to be in awe about what you teach. And it's a little piece of sand that you are helping that kid to be in awe. But helping them to go up, as Jesus invited these disciples going up to the mountain, is how you invite them to grow up and to awake in them the expectations and excitement that something new is there. That the life is beautiful, with new mysteries to be revealed. And once you touch the mystery and you start involving that mystery, you help them to be in awe about what you are teaching. Make the journey for something new and wonderful. The disciples never expect when Jesus invites them to go up to the mountain. Maybe they say, oh God, we are tired, Jesus, we are tired. We have been walking the whole day, and now another journey to go up to the mountain? Come on. But they follow him, and what kind of surprise is there? And that is what you have as a teacher, as a principal, that beautiful mission that is entrusted to you, to wake in your kids that are coming to you that desire for something new. And how that can happen? When you yourself are excited about what are you teaching. It's not, I repeat again what I taught last year. It's a piece of cake, I know everything. It's nothing new there. But how you make yourself anew, and you make every what you teach anew to you, that you become excited about what you are teaching, about the beautiful gift that you have in helping these kids to discover part of that beautiful mystery. Numbers, science, English, and English is crazy. Doesn't have rules. That is why I'm not concerned anymore to make mistakes, because English doesn't have rules. How the A sounds sometimes like A, or whatever. And you say, give me the rule. No, the pen of the world. Okay. There are challenges. But how you invite these kids to embrace the challenge is not easy. Going up is not easy, helping to grow up. But the only way that you can do that is when you feel excited about what you teach. When you feel in your heart that you have a treasure, that every time is new when you speak out that and make the other ones excited about what they hear and what they see. And that is when you make them feel important, part of that journey in which are called to discover something new and help them to see that it's possible on them to have good grades. I don't have that pleasure to have good grades in my high school, because you learn and you learn, that's it. It was not exciting me or learning. Or you learn. That is not a way to help in life. They are coming to you, to your class, looking for something, looking to enjoy what you teach. They are coming excited because I will have a new teacher. And when the kids say a new teacher, it's excitement there. And they smile. What are and how are you preparing? In what way are you preparing yourself to respond to the excitements of your new students? That is a beautiful challenge. We have our faith. And God entrusts to you these kids, that you can guide them to understand a little bit part of that mystery of creation through maths, science, language, all of these beautiful things. And they can see through you that creation is beautiful, is awesome, because you become instruments to help Jesus to present this beautiful truth through you in your class. We need to be excited every day for the opportunity that is in front of us. And you need to find the excitement for a new school year. You have reports of the kids who are coming to you. You speak to each other. And sometimes you say, oh God, these kids are coming to me. You are not excited. But exactly that is what is needed. It's not the comfort zone and where I feel good. It's the challenge that with these kids, I need to grow up in my way to appreciate what I have. And find a new way maybe to approach the kids, to let them become excited about what I teach. Going up to the mountain, not stay down, but make that journey with yourself first and see, oh God, today I found something new in what I teach. And I'm ready to share that. You share what you receive. And sharing always comes with love. Always comes with love. Recharge your hearts every day with love. You are in a Catholic school. Being Catholic or not, it's a Catholic school where the essence of everything is our faith. And the essence of our faith is the love of Jesus for us, who's these kids and looking to see in you. Instruments of Jesus, called by him, and saying to each one of you in your own position, in your own school, help these kids to go up to the mountain and see the beauty of life. Awake on them the desire to know. Awake on them the joy of learning. If it is difficult for them, find a way that through difficulties they can find that it's possible to have a good grade. And with that, you work with them in their self-esteem and respect. Challenges are always there. We come with gray hair, it's fine. But with a blessing of growing up and to discover something new, we can be like the disciples. Lord, we have been walking the whole day and you invite us to go up to the mountain. Please, Lord. We always find that excuses. And we are reluctant to going up to the mountain. And if we accept that invitation to go up to the mountain and see the beauty who is there for us to see, it is easy to share with our kids what we discover. how we live our faith, how we can be able to recharge our hearts and be instruments in God's service. Thank you for saying yes to teach. It's a big responsibility. And please, help the kids to see life with love. The ones who are able to see life with love, they have the key to move on in life. Life without love doesn't have any sense. It's plain, it's nothing. Give them, through your example of joy, the opportunity to discover that with love, the way up in growing as a person is possible, and make them excited about the beautiful new year that they come to you. Reach your heart with a lot of energy of love. Let your face shine as the disciples were amazed in the transfiguration, that the kids can see in you the first day that they feel important, respected, and loved. And with that, you can take off for the new year, for the new school year, and will be a beautiful journey of learning not only them, learning each other to move on in life and discovering the beautiful mysteries of life and the universe.